Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Viejo and today we're gonna cover 5 super obvious features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 340 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be selection overlay and selection outline. If you've been using 3ds Max since the World War II, then I guess some new features might disrupt your inner peace, like these blue selections. So whenever you select an object, it will have a blue tint. Not only that, when you hover across an object with your mouse, it will start having these yellow outlines, or blue outlines if you select an object. Now, I'm not a fan of this disco light show, so let me show you how you can disable these and revert Max to how it worked before. So you go to Customize, Preferences, Viewports, and here, if you disable overlay, then you've got rid of that blue tint. Now, if you still find all these blue lines, yellow lines a little bit overwhelming, you can go to Customize again, Preferences, Viewports, and just disable these two, and your Max will function like in the old days where the selection was only visible in the wireframe. Our second feature is going to be Mask Viewport to Safe Region. So whenever you activate Safe Frames by clicking on the camera name and just going to Show Safe Frames, you're gonna get these black areas that define your output for your render. But sometimes you need to access those objects that are behind these areas, and you would usually go to your perspective mode and then select them manually, or you would click here and just go to the magnifier to kind of enable them. But there is a way to permanently disable these in Safe Frames. So if you go to Customize, Preferences, Viewports, you have Mask Viewport to Safe Region. If you tick that off, your safe frames are going to be visible outside of the output. This awesome feature was provided by YouTube user called MasterWasp74. Thank you for that, this is an awesome feature. Our third feature is Chamfer Inset. Whenever you're doing any sort of modeling, and let's say I need to add some chamfers to this object, so I would go and probably use chamfer modifier. So whenever you add a chamfer modifier, let's say the amount something like this, let's put segments to 2, and the problem is, if I use Turbo Smooth modifier on top of that, Turbo Smooth will deform this vertical line here. If you take a closer look, you will see that our edges here are under an angle, so when we add Turbo Smooth, they will be deformed along the way, and this won't be a straight surface. So adding a Turbo Smooth is not a great idea, it's not the best result you can have. So to fix that, you would usually need to add some sort of support loop here to kind of hold the whole chamfer in place. But if you go to Chamfer Modifier, you have an inset section where when you click it, you have face inset and flow loop. Now, I'm gonna choose flow loop. So what flow loop does, it will create an additional support loop in the chamfer. Look when I turn it on and off what happens. Additionally, if I increase my amount to something like this, and when I turn on my Turbo Smooth, I will have my chamfers that will look far more defined and they will have an easy straight line. Now, on the other hand, in the same chamfer, when we press on inset, we have face inset and flow loop. What face inset does is, as you can see, it will add an inset inside of an area where the flow loop is going to make an inset around the whole mesh instead of this inside region. Our fourth feature is going to be rescale world units. I bet you all had situations where you would import an object inside of 3ds Max, and that object would be in an incorrect scale. It would be too large or too small. So, for example, I have this box here, which is 10 centimeters big, and I need that box to be 100 centimeters big. What I could do is click on my scale and switch 100% to 1000%, and I'm gonna get a 100 centimeter box. But the problem is, internally, Max sees that box still as the 10 centimeter box. So if I apply any effect to this box, like any modifier, like chamfer or some material effect, which is scale dependent, it's gonna still treat that box as a 10 centimeter box instead of 100 centimeter box. There's a way to reset your scene scale for specific objects. Well, usually that's done by X-Form. When you go to your utilities, you have reset X-Form, you're gonna go reset selected, And now this box will internally be treated as a 100 cm box. But the problem with X-Form is, X-Form will be added as a modifier, and sometimes you don't want that. But there is a different approach to solve this issue, and it's called Rescale World Units. So if I have my 10 cm box here, if I go to my Utilities tab, and if I go to More, you can see here Rescale World Units. So when you click on Rescale button here, and if you put scale factor to 10 in this case, you'll get a 100 cm box, but Max will internally treat it as 100 cm and you won't have an additional modifier. Our fifth and last feature is undo viewport operation. I bet you also had situations where you would just browse your viewport, so you would navigate your scene, you would have your render on a side rendering, and then you would come to this position, for example, and you would figure out this is a really nice view, so let me render this a little bit. And later on you would move, and you would realize that maybe that position was something that is worthy of an actual camera shot. So you would try to go back to that position, but that position would never be exactly the same. Well, there is an option to undo your viewport view. So if you do Shift Z, you're gonna return to the previous positions where you previously positioned your viewports. So for example, if I pan right, and if I do Shift Z, it's gonna move to my previous position. Keep in mind, I'm not using cameras, I'm in perspective mode. So yeah, this is a really nice trick. And from this point, you can go to your views, create physical camera from views or standard camera from view, and there you have your brand new camera. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. See you in the next known unknown depths of 3D Studio Max. Bye.